welcome to Lace TV again, Jill.
Thank you.
So you've got a graffiti strategy, and I think that's going in front of the council on Tuesday. So can you tell us more about the graffiti strategy? Because obviously that's a big issue in Brighton and Hove. It's got worse, I've said, in the last few years. Everyone would agree with that. So how can we go about tackling that?
Well, I think you're right. Graffiti has got significantly worse in the last few years. And it is a crime, but it's something that the council can't tackle all by itself. We have to work with partners. We have to work with the police, first and foremost. We have to work with community groups, schools, youth organisations. And so what our strategy does that's being put before councillors next Tuesday is to pull all of that together, to join people up, to sign up to this strategy, and then to put it into practice. And it comprises of prevention, enforcement, and education. So those are the three main strands.
Great. And we were talking about the cost of graffiti. It's £75,000, which, compared to the scale of the problem, isn't near enough. And obviously, tackling graffiti involves the police as well. So how do you think we can have a wider community approach to tackling the issue?
So the £75,000 is only the amount of money that the council spends on cleaning graffiti from its own buildings and structures that it owns, which is a lot of taxpayers' money, actually, to cope with this horrible crime that blights our neighbourhoods. So in working with the police, we are now going to, I think, reset up something that we had very many years ago, which is a combined database of photographs of tagging, where we can gather much better evidence. But also we want to work with youth organisations and with schools to explain about graffiti, to explain that it can be actually quite dangerous for people to try to get their graffiti up into some very inaccessible spaces, and to raise public awareness. We've got some amazing community groups in Brighton and Hove, not least in the North Lane, traders, also out in the Hanover area, that are working to obliterate graffiti as soon as it appears. And that work is to be commended. We want to spread that to other areas and to support those sorts of initiatives as well.
Great. And with that database, when would that be up and running by?
Well, we have to get the agreement from the committee next Tuesday,
yeah.
And I'm confident that we will. We will then progress all of this work straight after that. So as soon as possible is the answer.
Yeah, and that seems a sensible approach, because then the police can track where the... Because it's tagging, really. A lot of the graffiti in Brighton isn't... It's not actually beautiful to look at for most people. It's tagging, which I think the public find particularly offensive, just because it's not really... It's mindless, really.
It's mindless.
So that's a really good idea, I think, the database. And how can people report graffiti? Because I walk past it a lot along the seafront. So how can we do that?
The best way to report it is online, straight through into the City Clean or the council websites. Just go straight through to those and say where you've seen it, take a photo if possible, send that through if possible. Or you could report it to the police.
OK, great. And so let's see how the vote turns out next Tuesday. And Councillor Gill Mitchell, thank you for coming in today to TV.
Thank you very much indeed for having me. Thank you.
Thanks.